Today we are going to study a case study on Mayo Clinic. Mayo Clinic is a very popular health system in the USA, and USA President Barack Obama also appreciated Mayo Clinic the style of working or their work culture, and Obama believed that USA need such more Mayo clinics and such more organization which will work like a Mayo clinic to improve the health care system in the USA. So why US President is appreciating Mayo clinic, we will see in this case study, and why it is so successful, it is so popular, and what is the thing which how they are taking care of their patient, how they are successful in winning the confidence of the people, why they have huge customer loyalty, why their quality of the healthcare system is at the best in the world, that we will see. Mayo Clinic is the first and the largest integrated not-for-profit medical group practice in the world. So it is not-for-profit organization, and it is the largest integrated NGO, you can say, in the world. William and Charles Mayo founded the clinic over 100 years ago as a small outpatient facility and pioneered the concept of medical group practice, a model that is widely used today. Mayo Clinic provides, in the picture, you can see there are two founders, William Mayo and Charles Mayo, who have founded Mayo Clinic 100 years ago, and their model is successful, and it is the role model, or it is as aspiration for the other hospitals. Mayo Clinic provides exceptional medical care and leads the nation in many specialties such as cancer, heart disease, respiratory disorders, and urology. Mayo Clinic provides exceptional medical care and leads the nation in many specialties such as cancer, heart disease, respiratory disorders, and urology. So even though they are working as a not-profit organization, they are not restricted themselves to just only one or two segments. They are present in almost all the segments of in the healthcare. It may be urology, it may be respiratory disorder, it may be heart diseases, or it may be as complicated as cancer. You know that cancer is very difficult to cure. It consistently ranks at the top of the US News and the World Report's best hospital list, and it enjoys 85% brand recognition among the US adults. So because of its very good facilities and good quality of the service, they are among the best hospital lists, and they also has very good brand recall or brand recognition. It has reached this level of success by taking a different approach from most clinics and hospitals and putting a relentless focus on the patient experience. So at the Mayo Clinic, patient will enjoy the journey. Patient will not feel boredom. Patient will not feel he is alone. Patient will not feel that I will patient will not be worried about his health. So he will be confident about he will recover soon. One of the problem with me, whenever I feel sick or whenever I am hospitalized, every second, every minute is boredom, or I cannot able to enjoy the environment, or I cannot able to feel good in that particular environment. That's why we try to avoid hospitalization. But at Mayo Clinic, it is not the case. The clinic's two interrelated core values that trace back to its founders and are at the heart of all the organization does, placing the patient interest above all others and practicing teamwork. So you will see two important things at the Mayo Clinic. First is the patient's interest. What patient require? What is the requirement of patient, or how to cure the patient as early as possible? That will be the priority, and they will work to solve these problems of the customers or problems health problems of the patient in a team work. Every aspect of the patient experience is considered at the Mayo's Clinic 3 campuses in Rochester, Scottsdale, and Yorkville. So they have 3 campuses, and all 3 campuses are very big campuses. You can see in the on the slide in the picture. So they have campus at Jeffersonville, they have campus at Scottsdale or Phoenix, or and they have campus at Rochester in USA. The moment a patient walks into one of the Mayo Clinic's facility, he or she feels the difference. The patients are welcomed by the professional greeters who walk them through the administrative process. So unlike other hospitals where the admission or the enrollment of the patient is very difficult task, very cumbersome task, very boring task, here there are people to welcome you, there are people to wish you, there are people to greet you, there are people to receive you, there are people to welcome you. So this is the difference. They are taken care of every small things from start to end, from start to recovery of the patient. Returning patients are greeted by name and with the warm smile. So soon patients got recover, and it is their good service that makes patient recover in record time. And while leaving the place, they call that particular person by name and give them warm smile and send them with good gesture. The building have been designed so that, in the words of the architect of one patient, one the buildings are also good. You can see in the picture that their buildings have designed properly in very good design by very good architecture. The buildings have been designed so that, in the words of the architect one, the patient feel a little better before they see their doctors. So even they look at the buildings, or whenever they look at the infrastructure, they will feel better. They get the guarantee that they will recover as early as possible, even before they are not meeting the doctors. So that is the that is the power of the infrastructure, that is the beauty of the infrastructure, that people start feeling good when they are admitted to the hospital and even before meeting the doctor. The 21-story Gonda building in Rochester has spectacular wide open space with the capacity of adding 10 more floors. Fine art hang on the walls, and the doctor's office are designed to feel cozy and comforting rather than sterile and impersonal. So they have taken care of their all the infrastructure. Specifically, this Rochester campus is very good, and it is designed to feel comfortable to patient as well as to doctor. The lobby of the Mayo Clinic Hospital in Scottsdale has an indoor waterfall and the wall of the windows overlooking mountains. In pediatric exam rooms, resuscitation equipment is hidden behind the large cherry picture. Hospital rooms feature microwave oven and chairs that really do convert to beds, because as one staff member explained, people don't come to the hospital alone. The newest emergency medical helicopter was customized to incorporate high-tech medical equipment and is one of the most advanced aircraft in the world. So they also have one state-of-the-art, high-technology, most advanced helicopter, which will speed up the movement, or which will speed up the travel. It will immediately brings whatever equipments, material it is required. The another significant difference in the serving patient is Mayo Clinic's concept of teamwork. The patient can come to Mayo Clinic with or without physician's referral. So patient can directly come to the hospital, and there they will start testing and start diagnosing. It is not required anybody's prescription. At that time, the patient's team is assembled, which can include the primary physician, surgeons, radiation oncologists, radiologists, nurses, residents, or other specialists with the appropriate skill, experience, and knowledge. So if you have seen in most of the hospital, only doctor take the decision, specific doctor take the decision about what to do and how to solve that problem of the patient's health or patient's disease. But here they before they come together and before they take any step, they discuss with everyone who are involved. It may be physician, it may be surgeon, it may be radiologist, it may be a nurse, it may be any other specialist. So they sit together, they discuss on the case, they discuss on the history of the patient, and they discuss on the probable solutions, how to solve this disease, how to cure this disease, and they take action. So this is very good teamwork. Teams of the medical professional work together to diagnose patients' medical problems, including debating test results for hours to determine the most accurate diagnosis and the best treatment. So they ensure that what is the best solution or best remedy for that particular person. And after the discussion, after the long discussion debate, they take the decision with democratic style. Once the team consensus has been reached, the leader meets with the patient and discuss his or her option. So after the debate, after the discussion, after the team brainstorming, that solution, that remedy is discussed with the patient, whether he liked it, whether he wants to go with it. Throughout the process, patients are encouraged to take part in the discussion. If the surgery is necessary, the procedure is often scheduled to take place within 24 hours. A dramatic difference from the long wait patients experience at many hospitals. So in many hospitals, you will see it is unnecessary, it is delayed. The surgery, if it is required, they take long hours and they ask for heavy money for that, heavy charges, heavy fees. But here at Mayo Clinic, they will not ask for heavy charges or the heavy fees. They will do it at no profit, no loss basis, and they will do it immediately within 24 hours. Mayo Clinic's doctors understand that those who seek their care want action as soon as possible. Mayo's doctors are put on salary instead of being paid by the number of patients seen or the test order. So in other hospitals, it is the number of patients cured. Doctor's salary is given, a doctor is given commission or incentive or bonus on the number of patients cured or seen. But at the Mayo Clinic, doctor is on the salary, so doctor doesn't worry about doctors do not worry about the number of patients. They want to give the best solution, they want to cure the patient as early as possible. And here it is a teamwork, and in other hospital it's individual doctor's decision. And that doctor is in a hurry to earn more profit, to earn more commission, or to earn more incentive. As a result, patients receive more individualized attention and care, and physicians work together instead of against each other. So they are not competing with each other like other hospitals. They work with the synergy, they work in a teamwork. As one pediatrician at Mayo explained, we are very comfortable with calling colleagues for what I call curbside consulting. I don't have to make a decision about splitting a fee or owing someone something. It's never a case of quid pro quo. So when in general hospitals, when one doctor take the advice from the other doctor, they have to divide their incentive, they have to divide the fees paid by the patient. But here everybody is on salary, so they don't hesitate to discuss the issue, to take the advice from the other doctors or other staff. Mayo Clinic is a not-for-profit, so all its operating income is invested back into the clinic's research and education programs. Breakthrough research is quickly implemented into the quality care of the patient. So whatever they are earning the profit, they are again investing that in research and development. Though it is no profit, no loss basis, organization, then also some people may want to give them extra money because they are rich or they are comfortable with paying the normal fees. In that case they accept that money and they again invest back into the clinic research and development in education, and that again help to improve the quality of the health care in Mayo, at Mayo Clinic. Mayo Clinics offers educational programs through its five schools, and many of its physicians come up through these programs with Mayo's philosophies ingrained in their heads, including Mayo's motto, the best interest of the patient is the only interest to be considered. So they have a lot of schools. They have five schools, and there they have educational programs, and through the through that educational program, they are also generating manpower. And they have very good motto. Mayo's motto is the best interest of the patient is the only interest to be considered. So the best interest of the patient is the only interest to be considered. And in order that the sick may have the benefit of advancing knowledge, union of forces is necessary. So we should come together to fight against the diseases. We should come together to fight against the sickness, and we should have the good health care to all the human beings. That is the motto of Mayo Clinic. President Obama often cites Mayo Clinic as a key example in healthcare reform. Mayo Clinic has been recognized by the third parties for decades for its independent thinking, outstanding service and performance, and core focus on patient care and satisfaction. So Mayo Clinic has been appreciated by President of USA Obama and many other third parties and many intelligent people in the media or in the industry. Now there are some questions. Explain why Mayo Clinic is so good at the customer service. Why is it been so successful practicing medicine differently from other hospitals? So because they have very good infrastructure. First of all, they have very good infrastructure. When patient comes in, he is received by people with a smile, with greetings, with warmness, and there that patient become assured of his cure. And when he look at the infrastructure, he feel that even before meeting the doctor, he get the surety about his recovery, and he feel very better. And Mayo Clinic is providing each and everything which is required by the patient, and the patient thinks that we have been taken care by these people. We are in a safe hand, and they are working their level best. They are giving their 100%, and here I am assured about my recovery as early as possible. They work in team. So before taking any decision, they discuss on all the aspects. So there is very less chances of making error or mistake. Again, their doctors are not working on the salary. They have a lot of specialists. They almost have all the specialists. And they are working on the salary. They are not working on the number of patients cured or number of patients seen. So they can take advice from the other doctors, and they can work in a team, and they are not in a hurry to see the patient or to cure the patients like any other doctors. When they are in a hurry, they might create or they might give wrong prescription or wrong diagnosis. So it will not happen at Mayo Clinic. Again, whenever the patient cures and he is leaving that hospital, that time they greet them, they warm, there is warm send off, and they call the patient by their name. So they have expertise. They are working on the non-profit, no profit, no loss, on the no loss basis. These are the strength of the Mayo Clinic. So so we will again summarize the entire case. That time also you will come to know the strength of the Mayo Clinic. Second question is, do conflicts of interest exist between wanting to make your patient happy and providing the best medical care possible? Why or why not? So the question is cure the patient and to make the patient happy. Is it does it have synergy, or is it have a conflicting interest? So I don't think making patient happy and curing the patient is both the interests are in conflict with each other, because the curity recovery of the patient is mostly depend on mental state of the patient. If the patient feels that he can recover fast, that time only he will recover fast. Many times it has been seen that placebo effect is observed to in recovery of the patient. Whenever a patient thinks that he has been given the best medicine, he has been taken care the best, he recovers immediately in record time, that as compared to the other in other hospitals. So here, making patient happy will always boost the morale of the patient and morale of the relatives of the patient, as well as the morale of the staff of the Mayo Clinic, and that will speed up the recovery of the patient. So having good gesture, having warm welcome, having working in a team, having good infrastructure, and respecting customers by asking them, informing them about the decision, how we are going to do the surgery, or how they are going to provide them medical treatment. So if you are taking care of a patient as good as possible, as maximum as possible, definitely patient will be happy, definitely patient will cure fast, and both the things will not have conflict of interest, and it will definitely give good word of mouth publicity. And that's why we have seen that Mayo Clinic has huge brand recognition compared to other hospitals. So we again will discuss the first point. Mayo Clinic is so good at customer service. Why has it been so successful practicing the medicine differently from other hospitals? Answer is, Mayo Clinic's core values significantly help it to be very good at customer service. These core values include giving high importance to the patient interest and working in teams. In addition to these core values, some other aspects of its business helping it to be very good at customer service are speed of the treatment, environment of the comfort and tradition, professional individuals, specialist doctors, cozy private cabins of the doctor, etc. Mayo Clinic has been so flourishing exercising medicine in a different way from other hospitals due to the different approach of its founders. Second question, do conflicts of interest exist between wanting to make your patient happy and providing the best medical care possible? Why or why not? In the given situation, there are a lot of assumptions that can be taken, as it has not mentioned that the interest of the conflict is from whose end or from the management, patient, doctor, etc. Hence, on general wise, the following is stated. In my opinion, there shall be no conflict of interest in making the patient happy and giving the best medical care possible, as one is a micro aspect and other is macro aspect of looking at the given situation. The macro aspect is to give the best medical care to the patient, and micro aspect is making patient happy in providing small good warm gesture. Now summary, summary of this case study is like this. The Mayo Clinic is the largest integrated not-for-profit health clinic, and they have very good core values. All money is utilized for research and development and for the education programs. They have latest technology, they have specialists, and they are also working on the innovation, research and development. The intangible service they have made in a tangible form with the great extra care taken. Customers' needs are always considered a priority. Top quality staff and management committee is helping make it successful. So we discussed in one of the slides that Mayo Clinic ranked the best hospital for many years. So it is one of the largest cancer practices in the United States, treating more than 1,35,000 cancer patients per year. So this hospital, Mayo Clinic Hospital, has expertise in cancer, as it is one of the largest cancer practice performing hospital in United States, and it has treated 1,35,000 patients every year. Mayo Clinic's radiation therapy combines the state-of-the-art equipment with the expertise and compassion of the medical staff. Now about the environment of the Mayo Clinic. The buildings have been designed so that, in the words of the architect of the one, patient feel a little better before they see their doctors. The lobby of the Mayo Clinic Hospital in Scottsdale has an indoor waterfall and wall of the windows overlooking mountains. So, in one of the slides, we discussed the educational program, and they have got five different schools. So, first is Mayo Medical School, second is Mayo Graduate School, third is Mayo School of Graduate Medical Education, fourth is Mayo School of Health Sciences, and fifth is Mayo School of Continuous Professional Development. Now, second, again, we will discuss the question which we are asked. Explain why Mayo Clinic is so good at the customer service. Why is it been so successful practicing medicine differently from other hospitals? So, why Mayo Clinic is successful, and they treat the patient in very different way. So, what is the strength to provide all these facilities? So, key points are, first is they are very passionate about the patient care. They treat the patient as early as possible. They discuss before treating the patient, and they treat the patient quickly, promptly. They take the decision within 24 hours if it is a surgery. They have all the specialists, and these specialists are given salary, so they are not in a hurry, and they do not hesitate to take advice from others. They sit together, they brainstorm, they work in a team, and then they decide. So teamwork is another strength of the Mayo Clinic. Third, organization is non-profit based, no profit, no loss based. So it is at one type of NGO, so there is less chances of corruption. Then patients are also involved because they are treated very well. Then the entire infrastructure is in good manner. So it has got very good ambience. Interior decoration is also good. Integrating practice, education, and research. Their focus is whatever the profit they are earning, they are again spending or investing them on the research, then innovation, then education, and making providing good quality services. Do conflicts of interest exist between the wanting to make your patient happy and providing the best medical care? So I don't think there is any serious conflict. Firstly, the making your patient happy is more or less a long process because the whole process of the treatment is long. Of course, here the assumption is that the patient is happy after his treatment. Secondly, here, as providing the best medical care is like achieving a short-term goal, where the patient may feel a bit more pain, but at last, at least he can be convinced and prepared for it. So these are the location of their clinics. One is at Rochester, one is at Scottsdale, and one is at Jacksonville. Then in one of the slide, I discuss about the helicopter, that advanced helicopter, who is very technologically very advanced, and it helps for the quick recovery or the quick movement of the equipments. So this is the one. Then Barack Obama appreciated this Mayo Clinic that we discussed. Then in US News and World Report between 2015 and 16 ranking, Rochester campus of the Mayo Clinic ranked first in endocrinology, first in gastro and enterology, GI surgery, first in geriatrics, first in gynecology, first in nephrology, first in neurology and neurosurgery, first in pulmonology, first in urology, second in cardiology and cardiac surgery, so second in ear, nose, and throat specialist, and second in orthopedics, and third in cancer. So they are almost first or second or the third in their segments, in small segments in which they are working. So they have all kind of specialization that Mayo Clinic. So thank you so much for watching this case study. Kindly